అమృతవాణి
ఓ ప్రేమవాణి
ఓ ప్రేమవాణి
అమృతవాణి
అమృతవాణి
ఓ ప్రేమవాణి
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, grace and blessings of the Lord be always upon you. As we already know and always we have heard this, that there is a difference between listening and hearing. Both the readings of today complain about human failure in listening to God. We often hear the word of God. Every time in the Mass, when the person who reads says the word of the Lord, we see thanks be to God. But is that thanks coming from our heart? Is that thanks coming from a sense of feeling that we have just heard the Lord God speak? And when the priest says gospel of the Lord, are we really happy over the good news that we have just heard? When we praise, we say, praise be to God. Baruch, today we see laments that everyone has failed in listening to God and following God's commandments. He accuses God's people of following the sinful inclinations of their hearts, worshipping false gods and doing what displeases the one true God. Jesus in the Gospel laments the failure of Chorazin, Bethsaida and Capernaum in listening to the Gospel of repentance and redemption. In a class, all the students are seated in basically same kind of benches, same kind of education, same kind of lessons has been given to them. But not all become successful. Not all become Abdul Kalam. It is their effort, their hard work, their interest, their passion that makes them what they become. The same is here, dear brothers and sisters. The words of God are flowing. It is up to us to receive. And how much we can, that much can we receive. How much we would like to, we would receive that extent. In spiritual world, it is not enough that we hear with our ears. We must listen with our hearts, like Mother Mary did, like the prophets did, like Saint Francis of Assisi, the saint of whose memoria we celebrate today, did. It is very sad to see how people get their hearts hardened. They listen not to the Lord. His words do not reach their heart because they have blocked themselves from getting into the presence of God. Pharaoh's heart was hardened because he was blind to the love of God. Once Augustine came to experience the love of God, his life itself took a 360 degree turn. Do we have people who reject God in our lives? Or are we ourselves rejecting God in our lives? Is a question, dear brothers and sisters. Jesus couldn't do miracles in Bethsaida, in Tyre, in Chorazin and Capernaum because they rejected him. We have to make a journey from rejection to acceptance. Why should I accept Jesus? Why should I accept his word? Why should I accept him? Because I came from him. Because his words are truth. Because Jesus is my Lord. And anything other than that is a lie. So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, let us examine ourselves and see. So many times in our life, we hear this word, the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord. Is it the word of the Lord in my heart? Am I really accepting those words as the word of the Lord? Because if it's so, then I will not let it go out from the other ear, but listen to it, not hear. Get it into my heart and walk according to the word, and let my life become light. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Amen. Amen.